one, go!
I have no data on this fighter. I can't believe it.
It must be an intruder from another dimension.
Whoever it is, the goal remains the same. To fight and win! Is that Bowser Jr.?
Yes, he is the heir to the Koopa throne.
I wonder if his father bought him that junior clown car. It's decked out with all sorts of bells and whistles.
Hey, I just thought of an even better name for it. How about the Shellicopter?
Needless to say, the junior clown car is one tricky vehicle.
It's immune to many attacks, so strike when Bowser Jr. is exposed.
So what you're saying is to hit him from above, right?
That's one of the Koopalings. Ludwig von Koopa.
The resemblance to Bowser Jr. is strong.
That Koopa clown car is the mass-produced type.
I guess as heir to the throne, Bowser Jr. would get preferential treatment.
The relationship between Bowser and the Koopalings is a real mystery.
I kind of feel bad for them.
That's sweet of you, but not very conducive to taking them down, Pit.
I don't think I've seen that guy around.
Speed.
That's Shulk. He's 18 years old and clocks in at 5 feet 6 inches.
That's a pretty fancy sword he's got.
That's the Minato, the sword that defeated the Mechanus.
Makes us look like a bunch of jokers.
The Minato can change Shulk's strengths and weaknesses. For example, it might increase his jumping ability while decreasing his defense.
So for every strength he gains, he also gains a weakness.
Yes, and Shulk can KO opponents easier when they've sustained more damage. But if you know his weakness, he's not too difficult to deal with.
Let's not lose our heads, though. Hey, it's a shadow bug.
No, that's just Mr. Game & Watch.
Watch out for number 9, Pit!
What are you talking about?
Mr. Game & Watch's judge attack displays random numbers, and when it displays 9, the attack is devastating.
Getting hit with a 9 will knock out any fighter with a single strike, no matter who it is. When his back is against the wall, Mr. Game & Watch might try his luck with a judge attack.
Leaving victory up to luck doesn't seem like the best strategy.
Well, luck is part of every victory.
So you better watch yourself, Pit. Hey, look! It's Mega Man!
Is that really him? It is really him! Wow!
I hope he busts out his Mega Buster.
I want to see his charge shot.
Flame Blast!
Leaf Shield!
Rush Coil!
Metal Blaze!
Spark Shot!
Air Shooter!
Trash Bomber!
Smash Claw!
Flame Sword!
Hard Knuckle!
Game! Go!
Walk'em, 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 walk'em!
Yes, that's Pac-Man. He was born in 1980, which means he's 1 year older than Mario.
Oh, another industry veteran.
His most famous form is shaped like a pizza missing one slice. He has several attacks in this form.
But the main thing is to avoid him taking a bite out of me.
Yes, especially with those wings of yours.
What do you mean?
I bet they taste great with a little barbecue sauce.
Okay, enough about that.
Yeah!
Spike really isn't very spiky, is he?
Yeah, I've seen spikier. It's true that you're more likely to find him curled up in a cute, harmless ball.
Not so harmless. That round shape lets him spin dash with ease.
I've changed my mind. He's entirely too spiky.
Spin dashes are hard to stop.
Just keep your cool and don't lose focus. You can stop spin attacks using your orbitars or bow.
That explorer guy.
Did you know that Pikmin are named after Pick carrots, a vegetable native to Hokitate?
Huh. Guess you learn something new every day.
Enough with the pointless fun facts. Let's talk fighting strategy. Here's what I know about those Pikmin. Red Pikmin are strong. Yellow Pikmin fly high. Blue Pikmin have the mightiest throw. White Pikmin are fastest. Purple Pikmin are heavy and the most powerful. Be sure you remember all this, Pit.
Right.
There are also winged Pikmin that don't attack you. Numerous Pikmin will weigh down the winged Pikmin, and that's when you should attack.
Villager, huh? That's not a very creative name.
Well, what else do you call someone from a village? Anyway, you've got to respect the villager. Word has it no one fights fairer than that one.
Why's that?
Probably because where the villager's from, there's a mole who goes around punishing cheaters.
Rossetti!
Anyway, the villager's Lloyd Rocket can do some real damage, so try your best to reflect it back.
There's something weird about this fighter, Lady Palutena.
That's Robin, also known as the Avatar.
I wonder where Krom is.
Who knows? Probably taking a nap at home.
I'm no idle layabout.
Whoa! Where did you come from?
Robin is a skilled strategist and master of both 11 sword and magic. Certainly more useful than a simple swordsman like myself.
Too similar. No point in having two characters that are pretty much carbon copies, am I right?
Excuse me?
What's more, you don't have an ether recovery move like Ike does, do you?
Quite.
Back to the topic at hand. Robin can use the Levin sword and magic only so many times. Use this limit to your advantage, Pit.
Got it. This fight is in the bag.
I wouldn't be so sure. For Robin's final smash, I plan on lending a hand. Then you'll taste the bitterness of defeat.
We know you're trying to play the hero and all, but you can only join in if Robin gets the smash ball, right?
You'll taste the bitterness of defeat right after Robin gets the smash ball.
This now?
She's a Wii Fit trainer. She's an exercise coach of sorts. I hope you're in shape, Pit.
Well, I walk everywhere, so I'm probably fine.
Oh, of course. You're always at the beck and call of the Goddess of Light.
Well, angels are messengers of the gods.
That's where you're mistaken, Pit. Angels are nothing more than divine interns.
In any case, be careful of her sun salutation move. It gets stronger with deep breathing.
Who's that fellow?
He's a Wii Fit trainer. He's an exercise coach, more or less. Piet, do you exercise regularly?
You know it!
Is that because I work you too hard?
Oh, no! Serving you gives my life meaning. I just... I'll need to do a little cardio to keep up with your demands.
You're so sweet, Pit.
And always at your service, Lady Palutena.
Watch out for his sun salutation move. It gets stronger with deep breathing. Look at that cute little robot.
ROB isn't a very creative name for a robot.
I think it has a certain ring to it.
No way! Any name's better than ROB. Like, how about Mr. HVC-012?
That doesn't exactly roll off the tongue.
How about Robo Buddy 3rd Edition?
And what happened to the first two editions?
Oh, good point. How about Zerglotron?
Let's just keep things simple by calling him Rob.
The light on its head shows you the strength of the laser it's about to fire. The moment you forget about it, it'll unleash its laser at maximum power. So watch out!
Five, game!
This guy looks ready to fight.
That's a little Max. As a boxer, fighting is sort of his thing. No one can match his strength on the ground. But in an aerial battle, he's helpless.
So you want to get him in the air and keep him from landing.
He has a power meter that, once full, lets him unleash a lethal attack.
He seems tiny, though.
Maybe that's why he's Little Mac. But even with his small stature, he's triumphed over many heavyweight boxers. Pretty impressive for a puny human.
Bring it on! The stronger the opponent, the more interesting the fight!
That's the spirit!
I can keep using my weapons, right?
Ugh, yes.
Five, four, game!
I don't want to fight that cute dog.
Oh, you won't. You'll be fighting the dog and the duck.
So, if I win, is duck on the menu for dinner?
Let's take things one step at a time, Pit. These two may seem like a duo, but they're actually a trio. Together, they're known as Duck Hunt.
So where's the third team member?
Listen, just be careful. You could get shot out of nowhere.
A mysterious sharpshooter, eh? Well, that does make things more exciting.
Show me a move.
Whoa! It's Captain Falcon!
Oh, he's a captain! What ship does he command?
I think he's more like a pilot or something.
All these fighters have tons of skill and experience, but you can still hold your own. If we brought vehicles into the picture, though, that would be a totally different story.
Good thing that's not the case. I'd be no match for an F-Zero machine or an R-Wing.
Plus, those G-diffuser systems are terrible for the environment.
You sure know a lot about space machinery. For being the goddess of nature and all.
Anyway, if you're near Captain Falcon, watch out for his jump and Falcon Punch combo.
Falcon!
Five, four, three, game!
Picking up on some weird kind of energy here.
What you feel is Ness's PSI.
What's PSI?
It's a general term for supernatural abilities.
Supernatural? Isn't that pretty unscientific?
Said the angel to the goddess.
What are you getting at?
Pip, we're having this conversation via telepathy. Meanwhile, the power of flight is a type of psychokinesis, and I see you from the heavens using clairvoyance. Finally, I call you back from the battlefield with something akin to teleportation.
And believe me, I truly appreciate all that stuff you do. Which thing?
Anyway, if Ness tries to recover via PK Thunder and you reflect it, that will really ruin his day. Give it a try when you get a chance.
Five, four, three, two, one, time! Sudden death, go!
Game!
like it's me versus DK.
His arms are like tree trunks, so his attacks are incredibly powerful. Given his size, he also moves quite quickly. Combine that speed and power with his long reach, and you've got an opponent who's good at almost everything.
Yeah, except for dressing himself. That necktie really doesn't leave much to the imagination.
True, but it is his signature look. It's probably best not to mention it.
Yeah, you wouldn't want to be on the receiving end of one of his giant punches or smash attacks. When he attacks you, don't use your shield. Just get out of the way and then counterattack.
And watch where you come in for a landing.
Five, go!
Oh, look! It's Diddy Kong.
He's Donkey Kong's little buddy.
Wonder if he'd let me win for a banana.
Don't underestimate him just because he's a monkey. He's faster and stronger than any human.
As long as he can't fly, I'm good.
He can't fly, but he does have a peanut pop gun and an inexhaustible supply of peanuts to shoot at you.
So? I love peanuts!
Not when they're pelting you in the face.
I don't know. Still sounds pretty good to me.
Oh, Pit! What won't you do for a snack?
Fighting does take strength.
Anyway, if you can hit Diddy Kong at just the right angle, he'll drop his rocket barrel pack.
However, it explodes when it lands on the ground, so watch out.
Five, four, game!
Fire!
Got any tips for fighting Fox?
Fox McCloud is the leader of the mercenary flight team, Star Fox. His trademark is incredible speed.
It's about time you showed up, Fox!
That was a terrible General Pepper.
You should be wary of his blaster, too.
Everybody, stay alert!
Focus, Pit. You might think Fox's blaster doesn't hurt all that much and ignore it, but you'll soon find you've taken lots of damage.
Sorry, I'm back. Okay, I'll just reflect his shots with my Guardian Orbitars.
I figured you'd say that.
Huh? Is that not what I should do?
Like I said, he's quick on his feet, so there's no telling when he'll suddenly rush in and grab you. You've got to watch your back constantly when Fox
Five,
is around.
Four,
do a barrel roll!
Three, two, one, game!
Do you know who this is, Pit?
Falco Lombardi? Ace pilot on the Star Fox team? Great jumper!
Exactly. Captain Falcon's already got the Falcon motif. Falco looks more like a pheasant to me.
Sounds delicious.
If I were you, I'd keep your voice down. If he hears you, he'll make you eat his boots.
Falco used to be the leader of a galactic gang, so you can expect him to be good in a fight.
I'm starting to freak out here. I mean, this guy is famous throughout the entire galaxy.
Watch out for long-range attacks, like his reflector shot and blaster.
You'll see he's quick on the draw.
Five, four, game, go!
Wario kind of smells.
That's to be expected. For his final smash, he munches nasty garlic and transforms into his super anti-hero alter ego, Wario Man.
Wario Man?
Yes. Legend has it that Wario once caught a cold, accidentally ate a piece of nasty garlic, and turned into Wario Man.
Huh. So nasty garlic is the key to Wario's power. Great.
He's a real charmer, that one.
Speaking of which, eating seems to make Wario very gassy.
Oh, TMI?
I'm only telling you this for your own good. He's a ticking time bomb. Watch out for his sudden farts, and all farts in general. They're gross and dangerous.
Five, four,
it's really the
three,
worst sometimes.
Two, one, time! Sudden death, go!
Tell me about this fighter.
Here we have a Mii Brawler.
This fight's gonna be really easy if my opponent's unarmed.
Listen to Mr. Tuffy. guy here. That's pretty presumptuous to think that this fight's already in the bag.
Oh, like you're one to talk about looking down on others.
But Viridi's right. You can't underestimate this foe. The Mii Brawler is far from being unarmed. Those fists are weapons in and of themselves. They pack a real punch, so you should watch out for even straightforward moves like the side smash.
Okay, okay. No talking trash about any of my opponents. At least not until after the fight.
Game, go!
What do we have here?
That's a Mii sword fighter pick. As a general rule of thumb, you should take armed opponents seriously. Which really isn't easy in this case. That Mii is awfully funny.
No arguments there.
But Mii's are full of special moves, so it's essential to figure out what they're capable of quickly. They often have some unexpected techniques, too. If you get careless, you may find yourself in big trouble.
Game!
That gear looks like it belongs to Mega Man.
Or maybe Samus.
Wrong and wrong. That's a Mii gunner. All of them carry arm cannons and backpacks.
That backpack looks heavy, but that's because it's filled with different types of ammunition.
How do Mii gunners choose which type of ammo to shoot?
There's a motion-controlled trigger in the arm cannon.
So the stance they take when firing tells me where they're aiming.
Motion control? That's downright revolutionary! We should patent that.
Sounds like the goddess of nature has turned into the goddess of commerce.
Game!
It's always easy to pick Kirby out of a crowd.
Aww, he's so squishy and adorable.
True, but he's still a formidable foe.
He's got all kinds of moves, and he's top-notch at recovery. Does this guy have any weaknesses?
Just what you'd expect. His weight, or rather his lack of weight.
So it shouldn't be hard to send them flying, huh?
Right. The question is how to do that.
Oh, that part's easy. Just keep wailing on him. Then we'll see who's stronger. That little puffball, or Kirby.
Meta Knight looks like under that mask.
Apparently quite similar to Kirby.
If he took off his mask, could he inhale things too?
Maybe. And maybe he has Kirby's copy ability as well.
So if a maskless Meta Knight copied a masked Meta Knight...
Well, then he'd just be back where he started.
Anyway, be careful of his quick blade and his spinning attacks. They don't have a lot of power, so use your shield until you see an opening.
Who's this, Lady Palutena?
That's King DDD.
So, what do I need to know about him?
He's a heavyweight, but has the ability to fly. And his hammer attack is no joke. But every fighter has a weakness. For example, when King DDD throws a spiky Gordo, you can hit it right back at him. If you can eliminate him by reflecting the Gordo, that will count as your KO.
What's a KO?
Good luck, Bit.
Game, go!
This isn't quite the Zelda you're used to.
I hear she no longer changes form in battle.
That's right, but she's got a new special move. The Phantom Slash.
Where does she get the Phantom from?
It's hard to say. Magic.
Wow! I didn't realize she was such a powerful magician.
I could do something similar, I'm sure. But it's pretty dark magic. Now, what part of you should I use to make your Phantom?
My Phantom? You don't have to do that for me, Lady Palutena.
Oh, don't be scared. I'll just equip you and...
What will it cost me?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe just your soul?
Look how pale he got! You're really scaring him. Ugh, listen, Pit. If you can knock Zelda's phantom out, she won't be able to call it back for a bit. Keep an eye on
it. Time! Sudden death, go!
Fighters, Link is the one I most want to take down.
Oh? Why is that?
We were born around the same time. And we both use a bow. He's totally ripping off my style.
Please! Comparing Link to you is like comparing a star to a campfire.
What?
Just look at those chiseled features. His cheekbones could seriously cut glass.
Earth to Viridi!
Oh, I'm only kidding. The goddess of nature would never be interested in some careless monk.
Oh, humans aren't all that bad. I could introduce you to him, if you'd like.
If you insist.
Back to the fight at hand. Pit, you can reflect Link's projectile attacks using your guardian orbitars.
Just watch out for his dreamy claw shots.
2, 1, time! Sudden death, go!
I wish I knew Sheik's true identity.
It is one of the great mysteries of our time.
Are you guys for real? You can't be serious.
Compared to the other fighters, Sheik moves very quickly. Don't get overwhelmed by Sheik's speed, especially one-on-one.
Game!
Dwarf guy definitely has the evil look down pat.
He can sometimes take another form. As Ganon, he's known as the King of Porkness.
It's actually the King of Darkness. He's brought Hyrule to the brink of ruin more times than I can count.
My arch-villain database doesn't bring up anything about his past.
Wow. I didn't know you had that app.
A goddess must preserve some sense of mystery.
Huh?
One thing you should know, Pit, is that there are many different Ganons.
Just like there are multiple Links and Zeldas.
But don't let that confuse you. I've spent years studying Ganon canon.
Remember, Ganondorf is as heavy as he is powerful. Use that to your advantage.
This guy's eyes are the size of my head!
He must be the famous Toon Link.
Where'd he get that name from anyway?
It's probably because he looks like he jumped right out of a cartoon.
Ah, I see how it is.
What's the matter, Pit?
It's just not fair, Lady Palutena. One Link is handsome, and the other is adorable. They're cherry-picking the best Pits!
Oh, is poor Pit feeling a little insecure today?
Snap out of it, Pit! You have a fight to focus on. Here's the deal. Toon Link is quick, but lighter than regular.
Don't get distracted by his weapons or his intense cuteness. Just calm down and plan the best counterattack.
Game!
Aw, look at that cute little guy.
It's a Pokemon!
And not just any Pokemon.
Actually, that Pokemon is called a Pikachu. Pikachu evolves from Pichu, and when a Pikachu is fully evolved, it becomes a Raichu.
It's quite rare for a Pokemon to be more famous in its middle stage than its final evolution.
True, but Pikachu is a special case. I mean, it's the most famous of all the Pokemon.
Excuse me.
Hello?
What is it, Pit?
I hate to interrupt your musings on Pokemon, but I can really use some Smash Brothers help right about now.
Oh, right. I forgot where we were. Okay, here's a tip. Dodge Pikachu's thunder and then counterattack.
You can also zap Pikachu by reflecting its thunder back at itself. And nothing is more satisfying than that.
Game!
that's Jigglypuff, the balloon Pokemon.
Look at the way it floats! It must be light as air.
Don't let its cuddly appearance fool you. It's one of the most aerodynamic fighters out there. And it has a deadly attack called Rest. When Jigglypuff lands this move, the effects can be devastating.
However, that move does render Jigglypuff vulnerable for a short period of time afterward.
So, when you see Jigglypuff start to fall asleep, that's your cue to move in for the kill.
Gotcha. I'll be sure to keep an eye out for when it nods off.
Game!
Oh, wow! It's Charizard! Just look at those majestic wings!
Those wings might be majestic to look at, but they don't help much in the flying or gliding department.
A little short in the flight department? That sounds like a familiar predicament.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Oh, Pidge, denial doesn't look good on you. At least Charizard can use its wings for attacking.
And I can use my wings to fly. When Lady Palutena grants me the power of flight wings.
You know, I've always wondered if the power of flight would work anywhere besides your wings. Like your hair, for instance.
That's not funny. I'd go bold.
But I digress. Charizard has another attack called Flare Blitz. It's powerful but dangerous, even to Charizard. Either way, dodge the attack and keep your distance while waiting for your chance to strike back.
Lucario, what about it?
I've never seen a creature with a life force like that. It's like a current of water or a whirlpool.
Oh, you mean Lucario's aura.
Aura?
Lucario can sense the life force, or aura, emanating from all living things. As Lucario takes more damage, its own aura grows stronger.
Ingenious! Lucario sounds like a perfect fit for the forces of nature.
We need to focus on the fight at hand.
You focus on the fight at hand. I gotta catch my new recruit.
No, stop!
Pit, a wounded Lucario is stronger than it looks. Be extra careful when it's taken lots of damage.
What is that? Some kind of ninja frog?
That's the Pokemon Greninja. Its strengths are agility and speed. What looks like a scarf is actually its tongue.
As a defensive measure, I suggest rubbing spicy peppers all over yourself.
How can Greninja taste anything with its tongue hanging out like that?
It could be one of those rare ninjas that just eats very slowly.
What? But that makes no sense! Anyway, just tell me how to win.
Greninja creates throwing stars out of compressed water and unleashes them at high speed. This attack is called Water Shuriken. If Greninja starts to charge up its Water Shuriken, be prepared to reflect it back.
Game!
Metroid? That's Samus!
Just like Link isn't named Zelda.
And like Pit's name isn't Icarus.
Okay, this joke has officially run its course.
Moving on then. Pit, you can reflect Samus's charge shot with your Guardian Orbitars. However, Samus can throw a storm of shots at you. If you use your Orbitars too often, she'll know what you're up to. So try to reflect strategically, as opposed to your usual game plan.
Who's that woman?
That's Zero Suit Samus. She usually wears heavy armor, but not in this incarnation. Even so, she's still pretty powerful.
She has some pretty hurdy-looking equipment. Getting kicked by those jet boots has gotta sting.
You have a good deal of hurdy-looking equipment yourself, Pit.
Yeah, and can you believe that there's some fighters that battle empty-handed? Crazy!
It's all about discipline, not weaponry. Don't worry, though. When we get home, I'll enroll you in Palutena's boot camp.
That'll fix you right up.
Or I can just keep my weapons. Yeah, let's do that.
Anyway, Zero Suit Samus is a difficult target to hit. Keep your attacks sure and steady.
Game!
Mr. Fancy Pants here.
Is that jealousy I detect in your voice, Pants?
Why would I be jealous of Marth?
Well, he's a prince for starters. A handsome prince.
And you're just...
Anyway, Prince Marth's most dangerous attack comes from the tip of his sword. Avoid his blade when you're at mid-range.
So I should either attack him from a distance or get up close and personal.
He's got a counter as well, so be on guard when you go hand-to-hand. If you're attacking from afar, use items to improve your chances.
Game!
Does Ike look a little different to you? A little... tougher? His clothes look different. And his sword looks even more menacing.
Yes, I suppose you're right.
And he definitely hasn't aged well.
Well, compared to gods and angels like us, Ike is just a baby.
I don't know how old you are, Prince, but you don't look like you've grown at all.
Oh, like you're one to talk? How old are you anyway?
10? A goddess never reveals her age, Prince.
Break it up, you two. Back to Ike. He has a powerful side smash that will send you flying, but that's also his weakness.
He's very vulnerable at that time. So dodge it, strike back.
I claim this victory in the name of Sky World! Sky World! Sky World!
Yeah! Sky World! Sky World! Sky World! Sky World!
Game! Go!
That lady's moves are awfully similar to Marth's.
That's Lucina. She used to introduce herself as Marth, so certain similarities seem inevitable.
What? She stole someone else's identity?
Well, it wasn't quite like that.
Marth had become a legend by her time, the Hero King. So Lucina took that name to bolster the morale of her own army. Think of it as a symbol of hope in the depths of despair.
That's pretty deep.
You can't tell by looking at her, but I hear she's got a great sense of humor.
I'll try cracking a few jokes and see if that softens her up.
The tip of her blade doesn't deal as much damage as Marth's, but her attacks are more balanced, even if they are not tremendously powerful.
Game!
Hey! It's Batu!
Will you quit calling me that?
Now, where did you disappear to after the fight with Hades?
Actually, Dark Pit works for me now. He's an officer in the forces of nature.
What?
No way!
Just because we fought together once doesn't mean we're all buddy-buddy now. In fact, the Lightning Chariot and Phosphora are also both under my command. The battle isn't over yet.
Viridi's interests and mine just happen to overlap. So for this fight, I'll be happy to launch you into the stratosphere.
Your powers are perfectly matched here.
It all comes down to skill.
Game, go!
Reflect! Counter!
Wait a minute! Lady Palutena, you're fighting me?
Don't sound so dismayed. Think of it more as a sporting event and less as a massacre.
I really don't want to hurt you.
That's awfully presumptuous of you, Pit.
Please, I know better than anyone else what Lady Palutena is capable of. After all, I fought her once before.
Good luck, Pit. You're gonna need it. Of course, I won't be giving you any hints during this battle. Ready when you... And no powers or centurions, either.
You shall be purified.
Ready when you are.
Game!
Wait a sec. Is that Me?
It certainly appears to be the case.
You're awfully calm about this, Lady Palutena.
Well, we've been through a similar situation in the past, don't you recall?
Yeah, but it's still freaky. It's like looking through a twisted mirror. That reminds me. You know how Dark Pit came from a mirror? And why doesn't he move left when I move right, and vice versa?
Beats me.
But you're supposed to know everything. Don't you have an all-seeing eye and an all-knowing brain and all that?
My all-seeing eye sees you getting hit.
Oh, man, really?
I'm sure the true Pit would triumph over any doppelganger. So I guess now we'll see if you're the real deal.
I meant to ask you about one more thing. Have you noticed that I can kind of fly on my own a bit?
Actually, it's called jumping, Pit. Sorry to be the one to break it to you.
Game! Go!
Woo-hoo!
You know who this guy is, don't you, Pit?
Of course I do! It's Mario!
He was your first ally in the fight against the subspace army. What you may not know is that he's actually quite famous. There aren't many people who don't know who Mario is.
I don't know whether to fight him or ask for his autograph.
Fight first, fanboy later.
Oh! Do you think he'll sign my wings?
Game!
It's Luigi!
Always a bridesmaid, never a bride.
Oh, don't say that. After all, he even had his own year.
I don't remember that. Though I suppose if he's number two out of all these fighters, that's actually pretty good.
His attacks are no joke.
You're right. Have you seen his super jump punch and green missile? In some ways, he might even be stronger than his brother. Too bad about that unfortunate L on his forehead.
I'm sure that stands for winner.
Game.
It's Yoshi!
Let me get this straight. Yoshi lays eggs, but he's actually male?
You know that, oh goddess of nature?
There's nothing natural about this one.
Yeah, I see your point.
Well, all living beings contain both female and male elements. It appears that Yoshi is no different.
I wonder what's inside all those eggs. Chocolate?
Focus, Pit. If you use your shield when Yoshi's pulling off an egg roll, you can grab it. Keep that in mind.
I don't think that's a real doctor.
I wouldn't be so sure. He delivers crushing blows, so he must be very knowledgeable about anatomy.
He's a quack. I hear he treats viruses by randomly throwing medication at them. Doesn't seem very safe.
I'm so glad Skyworld doesn't have checkups.
Dr. Mario is slower than the regular Mario, but he's also more powerful. Don't get sent to the emergency room. You don't know what kind of treatment you'll get.
Game!
Oh, it's Princess Peach!
Guess she's taking a break from being kidnapped.
I'm so glad we never have to worry about Lady Palutena. She can take care of herself.
Really? Wasn't she imprisoned by Medusa for a bit there?
That hardly counts. After all, we were just freshmen back then. That would never happen now that we're more experienced.
Peach has been in plenty of scrapes herself, so she ought to be quite experienced. And yet, she never learns. Sometimes I wonder if she just lets herself get kidnapped for fun.
I don't know about that. It seems like tossing vegetables is more her idea of fun. She'll pelt you with them the whole match if you don't watch it. but she can't reload when she's jumping, so keep your eye on what she's up to.
Picture him deep in his castle, stealing himself for a fight.
Or, you know, playing golf, or racing a go-kart.
He's looking pretty aggro today. Must be because he's in a fighting game.
When Mario first fought Bowser, I hear he had to use an axe to chop down a rope bridge and drop the big guy.
It all sounds like something from an 8-bit action movie.
I won't lie. I'm a little scared.
Don't. Bowser may be powerful, but he also leaves big openings. Fight smart and look for chances to counterattack. And here we have Rosalina.
Yes, she's the keeper of the Comet Observatory and mother of the Lumas.
Why is that comfy pillow following her? I love pillows!
That is a Luma, and this is no pillow fight.
It does look pretty plush, I have to say.
You know, Rosalina seems kind of rough with the little guy.
There are plenty of Lumas, so losing a few isn't a big deal.
Not a big deal?
Lumas will sacrifice everything to protect Rosalina. They may not look like much, but they're powerful enough to send you flying, so be careful.
Rosalina!